Before Dr. Zaheda Bhabha's second baby was born, she discovered that her new daughter would need plastic surgery to enable her to lead a healthy and happy life. This marked the beginning of a very stressful time in her life, but it was also an opportunity for personal growth. Zaheda has since focused her practice on using aesthetic medicine to help her patients to lead fulfilling lives. And Kerusha met up with her to get the full story.
Anyone arriving at the practice is struck by the sense of timeless peace that characterizes the spirit of the place. And Dr. Zaheda Bhabha has the same calm and gentle approach to her work.
Although aging may be a daunting process for some, more and more women are taking control of how they age and ensuring that their beauty remains timeless. The concept of if you look good, then you feel good is definitely underpinned by the aesthetic industry. And Dr. Zaheda Bhabha has invited me to sit in on some procedures today. I can't wait to learn more. Dr. Zaheda, how are you?
Well, thank you. How are you, Kerusha? You're coming just in time. I've just put in the anesthetic for the patient, so she's going to need about 10 minutes so she can be ready for her procedure.
So what are we doing today?
It's like a mini facelift procedure, but we're going to use facial threads. Are you feeling nice and numb?
Yes.
We're going to start with our procedure. So we're going to use this needle to make a little hole there. We're in our insertion point. And then this needle goes through, and then I thread the thread. So what this thread actually does is that it's going to reposition that fat pad of her nasolabial fold. So she's going to be very happy when she's done. Aging is more than just skin aging. Our bones are aging, our muscles are aging, our fat pads are moving out of the positions where they used to be. These threads integrate into her face. They're going to soften, they're going to move the fat pads, and they're going to stimulate collagen. That collagen is going to stay there forever. And our job now, as aesthetic doctors, is to just delay that aging process. We're going to lift up the thread for her. You can see the tension in the thread when it's coming up.
Thank you so much for letting me sit in. You look amazing already. I'll see you in reception.
Thank you so much, Kerusha. I'm going to show you what you look like now after. See how nice your face looks.
Oh, it looks beautiful.
Can you see the trimming down here, the lifting? The lifted cheekbones, and if you turn a little, you see that thread under your neck there, just to define this jawline a little bit more. I'll see you in 2 weeks' time, baby.
Thank you so much.
Have a nice day. Hi, Kerusha. Sorry for keeping you waiting.
No problem. I think I have to ask you, when did you know that you wanted to go into medicine?
I knew right from the time I was little that I wanted to be a doctor.
And who would you say was your biggest influence growing up?
It was my mom and our family. Women were housewives. Nobody actually worked or studied. My mother was the most educated person there. She was a teacher. And that for me was so important because here I'm looking at this woman going, getting up every day, going to work, coming back home, you know, being an influence like no other. And for her, education for us was key.
And the decision to go into aesthetics?
I was like every other aesthetic doctor until I was expecting my daughter. I found out kind of quite early in our pregnancy that she was going to be born with a cleft lip and palate. And for me, that was the turning point in my aesthetic career. Because for the first 3 months, there was this gaping hole in her face, which needed to be fixed. And when she lay there on that bed, you know, with the sutures on her face, and I just thought, we have to do something. I've got to give her a normal looking lip. And that's when it started. My older sister, when she get a purpose, then she will start helping me research. Okay, we can do this, we can do this. We need to buy this machine. We need to go here, we need to go there. And that's how Beauty and Curves was conceived, because we were looking for scar revision for her, that we built this whole practice. And so now we can help a whole, you know, different dimension of patients and give them the help that they need so that nobody needs to walk around with a scar that they're unhappy with.
When one thinks aesthetics, you think superfluous and frivolous, but this is where the real passion lies of changing someone's life.
For me, you know, giving her the confidence to have to deal with her daily life, to be able to walk out there and say, I'm going to be the best that I can be, is huge.
Now, I know doing lips is still one of your favorite procedures to do.
They say so much about a person, and it's not necessarily that big pouty lip. It's, you know, you may just have a very thin lip and you put your lipstick on and it's going everywhere. And a person like that will appreciate a more voluminous lip. Or when you get older, our lips tend to curl inwards. So when you just look at someone, you know exactly how old they are. So to fix that kind of lip also, you know, gives you a lot of satisfaction. So That's actually our next procedure.
Great, let's do it.
Let's go through.
Dr. Bhabha's extensive experience enables her to achieve noticeable results with the subtlest of interventions.
Here's our patient. If you can have a look at her, she's already got beautiful lips, but she just wants a little bit more volume. And she wants more definition on her top lip and a little bit more projection on her lower lip.
Well, I'm sure she's gonna look gorgeous. She's already so gorgeous, but I think I'm done with needles for the day. Thank you so much for spending time with me today. I've truly enjoyed it, and your story is really inspiring.
It's been a pleasure, Kerusha. Thank you.
Dr. Bhabha's patients include TV presenters, celebrity chefs, DJs, businesswomen, and pageant contestants who appreciate her ability to tweak what nature has provided.
In today's world, medical advances have come so far that almost nothing is out of our reach. But spending time with Dr. Zaheda Bhabha has reminded me that the one thing that is irreplaceable is our passion.